welcome once again to a brand spanking new build. In this one here, we are going to be building the Battlestar Pegasus. Now, the first thing you want to do is you got to make sure everything is here. Nothing broken off the trees. Everything looks good. Not too bad. Got the plans here. So it's pretty straightforward. Now, with here, it shows the decklings that came with the model. We're not going to use those at all, because I special ordered in from JT Graphics the actual runways here for the, each bay. And I also got the photo etch that I'm going to be installing on this brand new model. So this is going to be some pretty nice stuff here. Already got the pre-cut windows and everything in it, so which is awesome. That saves on a lot of drilling. And this is the interior side walls for the landing bays. That's what those are. And then so this is going to make my job just a teeny bit easier, but it's going to be a little bit of work to get these on there. And I'll show you why in future part of this build here. So this is good. All right. Okay. So I just, before you start, read through everything here first, so you understand it. And so everything looks good. All right. Now, before going about and painting the parts here, you see there's a lot of flashing here that needs to be trimmed off on all the model parts here. It's all over the place, so I'm going to get that done before I actually start painting the model. I'm going to paint the rest of these parts directly on their trees. It just makes it a little bit easier to do. Okay, so let's get that done. So I got, actually, it's large enough, I can just use my clippers here. Clip off the worst of it. And then use this. Sand it smooth against the body. Okay, we're ready. Okay, so I'm priming the inside first. Okay, now that the inside is done, I'm going to do the priming on the outside as well. Okay, now I need to work on this, the photo etch, the windows that go along here inside the trench of the Pegasus. It gives you a choice here. You can see one has like the little circles for windows, and the other one's more elongated. Now, I have the drill bit for these, but I don't for this. So for this, I choose to use these ones here because that's the kind of windows that they used in the TV show. So what I need to do here is I have to take my drill and I have to drill out the plastic all along here. Drill it all out and then replace that with that. That's the only way it's going to work, to be able to let the light through the windows. And I'll just take my snippers here. First one that goes along the very top here. 8, 11. Boy, these instructions are not very well thought out, are they? Okay, that's not gonna work. So I just have to use my X-Acto. Okay, now this is Okay, now I got a nail file here. This is the port. Port is this side, okay. Is it this?
Ooh, yee-hee!
Yep, that's going to work beautifully. Just have to shave this back a little bit more. As all the angels sing. Boy, that sure saved a lot of time on drilling, I can tell you that right now. That is looking good. So make sure it's going to fit in okay before I glue it into place. It fits in nice and smooth and snug. I want to get these in place before I put the final hull color on. So that's how this is done here. Okay, so let's get all these in place. Okay, now on the inside, I use the tester's window maker on the inside, and it helps to disperse the light so it doesn't look like it's coming from one source. It evenly distributes the light throughout all the windows. Because I'm going to be using LED line all the way through on either side here to light up all the windows properly. So I don't even need fiber optics for here at all. So now I'm just going to finish off the rest of them here. There we go. So I got them in there real nice. That's good. Take them up there. Looks good. Nice. Okay, so I'm done with this. Now I gotta put the emblem here on this part of the hull here. Now the wings is so here face aft of the ship, so I gotta make sure I orientate this properly. And then after that, I gotta do, well, the nameplate of the Pegasus goes on, and then all the side pieces for the arms going to the landing bay arms goes on as well. And we got the Viper launch ports go along the sides on the inside here. So I got to get those on there as well. Okay, here's what I got done so far. I got the Viper launching ports there, and the other details along the edges there. This is the center point between the upper and lower landing platforms. You got that on there. Looks really good. Now, I have to scrape off the raised lettering here for the Pegasus so I can put this on. Now, I can't put any of these on yet because they go along the sides here. I have to wait until I get the upper and lower halves together and ready to put onto the Pegasus main body itself. So that's going to be a little while away yet to put those on. But other than that, I just got to scrape this off, put the new nameplate on, and it's ready to go for painting. Alright, now let's get this all painted with the proper hull color. That's it for this build, everyone. Now that everything is ready to go, in the next one we are going to be working on the landing bays. So please like, subscribe, comment, don't forget to share, and make sure to click that notification bell so you're aware of the next episode. Also, check out my online store at the Teespring and my brand new website at epicmodels.com. I'll see you all again later. Bye-bye.